Indiana.
Hot Sunny Day has evolved into much more than barbecues and boat races. Its meaning increasingly under debate. Not just what the day was, nor what it is today, but what it might become. The aim, however.
It's a weapon.
Right? Oh, okay. So it's nice meeting you.
What's
your name? I'm Michael Gazan.
Michael.
Yes, I was here.
Karma. The Greeks have a concept called karma.
Is it Michael Gazan alone? How are you?
Very well.
You remember me?
Yeah, good, good, good.
How are you doing?
Good.
You're
doing, how are you?
Good.
This is
Mr. Kebab.
Yes, yeah.
In person.
Yeah.
Let's host to the
Bourbonis.
Yes. Are you getting combo for days?
This is a toast to the Rupa Dunnis.
There we go, yamas.
We're talking about you. How old are you now?
57. No, I'm
43, 1980. So were you married before?
No. It's my girlfriend there. It's my girlfriend home.
This is your girlfriend, huh? Can I come to you? What's he like?
What's he like?
Yeah, what's he like?
He's very nice.
He's very nice.
Very lucky.
What's nice about him?
Sorry, I'll put your foot in it now.
Yeah, I know.
Zucchini balls.
Yeah.
Your favourite salad.
Yeah.
And we got the salad, chicken and rice for Mr. Kazan.
And where's the fish? Is it Mr. Kazan?
Very good.
Very good?
Excellent, yeah.
What's your favourite?
I have forgotten about the Australian takeaway.
You certainly like hit the right spot.
Yes.
Certainly yes. Beautiful, thank you.
Bit of a, yeah, good, good. I'm glad I did. I would have fixed chips and meat for my
girlfriend.
Yes. Yes.
Did you
my
get that?
Dad and my mum 30 years ago.
Did you notice that? Whoops, yeah. Sorry.
All right, take care. I'll tell her.
Thank you.
I'll tell Angelo you said hello.
Yes, but yes.
We'll be happy to hear you.
Don't worry. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Go ahead. Oh, thank you.
Yes. Have you met anyone of the other students?
No. Oh, wow. You're getting better.
Hey, can I come to me?
I don't remember, but
nice to see you, nice to see you.
This is the scenic part.
Yes.
Do you know where you are?
I know where I am now.
Yeah, where are you?
I can see.
Where are you? Enjoying Canberra?
Very much so. Yeah. I must admit, even though I can't recognize most places, but I still feel that I'm in Canberra.
Yeah. That's what it's called. Oh, no.
Autumn leaves, you have autumn
leaves? We don't have any trees.
No trees?
Actually, we have the, what do you call them? The navel oranges and olive trees. That's all we have. And all of them, they keep their foliage around the year. Only in Zapier we have jacarandas, and they are in bloom now. It's beautiful, it's really, but we have plane trees and things like that, I mean, in Greece, and I'm sure they change the color in autumn, but you have never seen them.
So tell me
never
about
the place where they are.
Tell me about it.
Was one of the best person work at Hellenic Club. You know, it's, we love him. You know, I'm glad to see him today here.
It's beautiful, isn't
it? You know?
Also at the church, too. He's sitting in the church, isn't he?
We missed him a lot.
As well as cars, it's true. Yeah.
So, you know, he comes to see us. We talk a lot on Facebook. Yeah.
And,
that's how we see each other. We talk to each other.
He works as a postman. So, and I was doing Ocona and Sabo Connection on a push bike. And then somebody, something hit me on the head. I put my hand, I saw blood.
I thought that somebody threw a stone. I looked around, I couldn't see anybody or anything, and then I could see the magpie. How did I fall off the back? I would never know. Yeah. Welcome to Canberra, Mr. Kazan. But, and then every time I went around, it was Hyde Park, so I was holding the bike with one hand and he had the stick with the other.
Yes, I'm saying it's
that was one veterinarian, and the other one was with the dogs, because we had to blow the whistle for people to come. And there was Mila Street, where there were a lot of army people living. A very basic housing. So, the dogs will come and circle me and bike, and I get off the bike and jump one way and try to protect myself. And there was a house also, a beautiful house actually, and they had a dog and it was barking like mad. And the lady would come out to pick up the mail. She says, "Don't worry, it won't hurt you." She says, "It doesn't sound like it." Yeah. Incredible.
He keeps circling, the magpie keeps circling.
Yes.
He wants another bite.
Oh, the small one.
So did you know then you were going to stay in Canberra?
Sorry?
Did you know then, at the beginning, did you know you were going to stay? In winter time you arrived in June,
well,
it was cold.
You see, the thing was that...
What time is the meeting?
6 o'clock in the evening.
Oh, is that right? Yes.
And then we can have dinner afterwards if you like.
I just make a... I'll come and say hello to everybody.
That'd be good if you could. Yeah. I'm sure she'd be glad to see
you. I read you were on the door.
Yes, well, I didn't. Is it Sophia? I walked straight past it. It was so lovely to see you. We've got family here now.
Both my sisters, none of them ever dyed their hair. What's the
Yeah.
You know, that's been of age and good with the colors they are.
Yes.
They both look so well.
I
was so sad when I was tired and then Jim and I thought.
Former president of the of the Greek community.
Yeah.
Pate? Mesa. Oh. It's Mesa. That's it. No, Mesa for bus, for buses. Isn't it beautiful? What would you like for breakfast?
Sorry?
What would you like for breakfast?
Oh, I'll have a croissant, I think.
So, where are we going now?
Sorry?
Where are we going now?
Now we're going to Quimbien. As there's a Greek church there too.
Thank you.
When I applied to come to Australia, they asked you where you want to go, because I came with the assisted passage system. So the Australian government paid for my fare. It cost me nothing. Thank you.
Thank you.
So this is what it looks like, huh?
Wow, that looks lovely.
Doesn't it look beautiful?
Yeah.
Sure does.
This is your roots. This is what the Turks have been having for thousands of years.
Yes.
Good luck with coffee.
So, and I chose Canberra.
Excuse me.
Because it was the capital. And I thought, I was expected to see skyscrapers and everything, like a big city. But looking in the retrospect, it was the best choice I could have made. Wow. Because the Greek community was very small, so
what was very small?
Canberra.
What do you think?
And therefore, it was easier to make friends with non-Greek background. Because it, you know, forced me to learn the language.
What do you think of it?
It's very nice.
Isn't it beautiful?
Absolutely.
It's a winner. That one, you put that one back and have this one.
No, nice. This is with the spinach, yes?
He's not going to put it back in it, so.
Why would he put it back?
There's got meat in it.
Oh, all that's got meat in it.
Yeah. Salami. Salami. Just
this is with the sausage.
He's not going to put it back.
I might try a piece with salami. He ordered tabbouleh.
Tabbouleh.
Mm.
thank you.
Thank
you. So, what do you think of your first Turkish meal?
Yeah, lovely.
Lovely, isn't it?
Honestly, I never had this before, never. Even though I've been to Turkey a couple of times.
And you never eaten turkey?
Right. Sorry?
But I never had this one, this type of food.
This is their pizza. So here's some more Turkish food, huh? Maybe next time when we come to Greece, we'll go to Turkey.
Yeah.
Istanbul. Or Constantinople.
When I was the president of the Greek community, I was taken to the Ottoman, it was called, because it was a Turkish, very exclusive. Yep. That was lovely too.
He's reopening, actually. Sharif is going to reopen here.
Chris Michalis has taken me and the Greek ambassador and Konikias.
Wow, good to meet you.
Good to meet you too.
You look very dapper. It's nice to see.
Well, I forgot how cold it gets in Canberra. So
are you here now?
I'm really one of the people I most admire is your father.
Well, you should see him before you go.
Yes, actually, we went there the other day.
He's too busy.
Who?
Your father.
Yes.
Mr. Too Busy.
Yes, but I saw him in the church, so briefly I talked to him, yes. So they start the classes from 5 o'clock, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8.
And what did you do in your time? What did you do in your time?
In my time, I was not directly involved with the Hellenic dancers. Something just started long before I started the Hellenic club, but of course I always was very supportive of what they were doing and were trying to use them as much as possible in any activity I organized.
Is she?
Well, actually, it was worth coming just meeting Nectar.
Yeah.
He looks a lovely young man.
It's nice, isn't it? It's like home, isn't it?
So they're people from Agia Paraskevi.
Really? Agia Paraskevi?
So, and they even, I think, next week, too, because they spent 6 months in Canberra, 6 months on the island, in Agia Paraskevi. There's two of them.
They're waving to you.
Eh?
They're waving to you.
Yes, I know it. But at the same time, though, one must admit that the job done by the Hellenic dancers is unbelievable.
They're doing very well.
It doesn't happen anywhere in the world. It's not only they dance very well, they bring people together.
Mm.
And, you know?
Yeah, I think that's probably the most successful
yes.
thing going on
yeah. yes.
of cultural activities
yes.
now.
And the other thing is, it looks like it's going to continue. It's not going to stop. It's not going to disappear like other.
I think it's sustained. Yes. Sustained.
I'm interested in Greece because at school I did French and Latin. Latin came from the Romans. The Romans came from the Greeks. I'm a math science sort of person. So I'm interested in, and also the philosophy, democracy, so many things about our Western culture come from Greece. So I've always been quite interested. And when I went there, of course, I loved the climate, the lifestyle, the food, the ancient buildings, obviously the Acropolis and other ones, Delphi. I've also been to the Olympic Games site. And Napoleon. I've forgotten the name. What is the town above Sparta? I've
just Delphi?
No, that's Delphi.
Well, I'm very impressed anyway. So that made you learn Greek?
Yes.
Because he's going to come down any second.
So I was interested in... One reason I chose to learn Greek is it was a different alphabet. I thought I'd just do something a bit more challenging. That was the other reason. That's a strange reason.
So what made you choose him?
I saw it advertised in the Hellenic Club that he ran courses, and I rang him on the last day and said, can I do a course? He said, of course you can. It doesn't matter. You can enroll at the last minute. So I did. And here we are, 15 years later.
15 years later. Well done. Thanks. So he's a good pupil? He's still learning.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
Thank you. So
great to see you again.
Have a good
thank you.
Excuse me. Hello. Fancy, yes. Fancy seeing you here.
Yeah.
What are you doing here? Weren't you here?
Where's your key?
The night before.
Where's your key?
Just a moment. I get a lovely license.
Oh, good.
Lovely.
Where's your key?
Didn't take the key with you.
Oh, no, I didn't.
I lost the key. How are you going to get in?
You've got the key?
How are you getting in, huh?
Oh, well. So, actually, we've got your dinner here now with another couple. So, but I came out to have a cigarette.
Come on, let's jump in the car. Let's go. Come on, let's go. So what you been doing? I think you better have just shift the bed here.
Sorry?
I think you better just shift your bed here. Sleep here.
Well, actually when I was looking to my students, they said, oh, I have to go and see the CEO. And I said to them, if he offers me a job, I'll take it. The way after the conversation, all the discussion, all the things and talking about good old days, really, because I was very happy to meet the minister. Was saying to Annette, I had these people in mind, I would love to meet them, and I didn't know. I sent messages, and much to my surprise, all of them, they were there.
So how many turned up?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 with including myself.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
So you're having a beautiful day.
You say they didn't stay all for lunch.
That's your phone.
You're a popular man, aren't you?
Hello, Nick.
Hello, Michal.
How are you, mate?
Kalaise.
No, Kalaise. City Kanis.
Where's Nick? I can't see him.
Nick Samios. Yes, it's actually I'm outside the club talking to Manuel and Annette. I'm staying with them, but today I went out to lunch meeting some of my old students. It was very nice.
Nice. Are you around tomorrow?
I will be at the club. Yes, all afternoon.
Tomorrow afternoon, so if we meet up tomorrow about 6.
Yes, I'm having dinner with Theo and Raylene Politis. Do you know Theo?
You what, sorry?
Do you know Theo Politis?
Yeah, rings a bell.
Yes, anyway, I'm meeting with them. I'm having dinner with them at 6 o'clock. So I will be here.
He wants to have dinner with you.
Huh?
Okay.
He wants to have dinner with you.
Oh. So,
he's a very popular person.
Oh.
We lost him.
I lost him.
So, did you ring him or did he ring you?
He rang me.
So, how come he rang you?
Oh, and I can...
How come he rang you?
Probably he rang me through Messenger, yeah. Because we were friends.
Not
the
physically,
thing. And
because he saw you on video?
Yes, what I was going
did
to
say. Did he see you on YouTube?
Sorry?
Did he see you on YouTube?
That he will meet me?
Did he see you on YouTube and inspired him to ring you?
Yes. No, because we're friends on Facebook and things. And one of my students, and I was too embarrassed to ask for the surnames, he's seen all the videos you put lately on YouTube.
So he saw it. Good, good.
Yeah. So, I ring him back. What?
So who we got here?
Whom have we got here? It's Eleni Kipridis.
And my husband,
Berend.
Michael.
Berend.
Berend. Is good Greek name?
A good Dutch name.
A good Dutch name, yeah.
So you must you're together. Have met before.
We have met before. He's done video work in my exhibitions.
Oh,
really?
Oh, yeah. It's been a while, hasn't it?
Oh, very long
so
time.
Would you like to drink?
Yeah.
We work at the gallery, too.
I work at the gallery
so
still.
So what was your surname?
Kipridis. Kipridis.
Riesling?
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah. That was it.
Filming all right. Yeah. I just come to see how the standards are going these days, you know.
Can you order some?
See if they're up to scratch, you know. I've got to report to my dad tomorrow.
How is he?
Doing much better.
Yeah.
Doing good.
Like
he should be... they're ready to discharge him from the hospital, but then we'll look to get him in the rehabilitation hospital for 6 weeks. So he's doing really good, doing much better. Yep.
Εδώ το βλέπω συχνά.
Of course. Γεια σου Μανώλη. Εσύ μη χάσεις. Always. I think there is a new generation camera you can put in your eye.
I want to take the heaven with me.
Καλά είναι, καλά είναι.
Εκεί είσαι στην Αθήνα.
Στην Αθήνα, στην Βάρκεζα με, no?
Gunning,
so you were saying, places. You were saying?
This was one of my pieces from the exhibition in Gunning that I had last year. And 99% recycled materials. So from the nuts and the bolts right through to the object itself, they're all recycled, reused materials. Cleaned up, found objects to make them into useful pieces again. So if they can work as they were originally intended, then I keep them that way. But if they can't work anymore and they're not functional, then I make them into something else. And so it was a reasonably successful exhibition for a first exhibition. I sold 17 pieces, so in the current market, that's a good result.
Very good.
So big price numbers or just $350?
$350 right through to $1,500. So there's a range of items, and the artworks, as in the two-dimensional artworks, the paintings that I sort of fixed, they were down from, you know, very accessible prices of $50 right through to hundreds.
Where did you find this?
That was in St. Vincent de Paul for $9.
Wow.
And it was because it was in the wrong frame and it hadn't been taken care of. So I cleaned it, reframed it to a museum standard, put it into an appropriately attractive frame, and then put it on exhibition. So I'm not saying that the two-dimensional pieces or the two-dimensional artworks are mine, but they should be seen again in an attractive way. And that was the whole basis behind the exhibition. Things that other people have thrown away that they no longer saw value in.
Well done.
Thank you.
There's a great catalogue too.
Thank you.
This is a catalogue or this is a...
This was my catalogue to show people that there was additional information for the pieces.
So when you had the exhibition, you gave these away?
Nope. No. Well, at $40 a piece, I didn't think that was appropriate. But they were made specifically for extra information for those who needed it.
Beautiful. And your name?
Berend. Bernie.
Bernie.
Yes.
Ernie what?
Kark. That's the fellow, yes.
That's him there, is it?
That's me there.
Look alike, isn't it?
Similar. That's from leftover paint off of frames that I was painting, and I thought, oh, that looks nice.
That's beautiful.
So,
oh, well done. And what's this one here?
Oh, this was a joint exhibition that was on at the same time as that one, and I had three pieces in that exhibition as well.
So where was this exhibition?
That was in Gunning at the...
out in the country.
The Picture House Gallery, which was lovely. Yeah. Beautiful building, Art Deco building. And this one was in Griffith. So
Griffith,
a place called
M16.
Yes.
M16.
Yes, the old Griffith Primary School.
So that's the one I was pointed out to yesterday.
Yes.
So, yes, good fun.
Everyone.
Cheers again.
Cheers. Cheers.
Kalyan
Dhamma Sistin Alada.
Yes.
What's the good thing?
Elena is coming to Greece just two or three.
About a week before you?
Before me.
Lucky duck.
I know. Well, I haven't been for 5 years, so it's high time.
So where do you know him from? Where do you work from him? Because of the exhibitions?
No, I work at the National Gallery.
But your association with Michael?
Oh, I know Michael
through
because
classes.
I initially started doing Greek lessons here many years ago, and then my husband was putting on little exhibitions for Michael and then doing some stuff for the ambassador and his wife. So we had a lot to do. Do you ever hear from them? Not at all. Yeah.
Which ambassador is that?
Eva and Harry.
Yes. Not the one who was explaining about them.
You see, what had happened, all the posters, if their children spoke Greek, they always put down the other kids who didn't speak any Greek.
Yeah.
And I was trying to tell them that language does not give you nationality.
No.
So, and the best example was Emmanuel. She didn't have an act for languages. But who can deny his feeling about and his mentality and his thoughts and his work and everything that's not Greek?
Manuel, did your parents speak to you in Greek when you were a kid? Never.
Well, they did.
Did they speak Greek at home?
But your mother was born in Australia, wasn't she?
Yeah. They were in the country town, everyone was English and he didn't talk.
As I said before, language, you don't have to speak a particular language to be called that you're national of that country. People were born in Australia, educated in Australia. They're Australian Greeks, not Greek Australians. I'm a Greek Australian, but my children are Australian Greek. And, you know, a lot of people use the fact that their children spoke better Greek than the children of the others and put the other children down. That was absolute criminal.
So, about me being the worst pupil you ever had. Tell me that story.
Sorry?
Tell me the story about me being the worst pupil you ever had.
Well, not the worst, because there were others like you.
You weren't the only one. Come on.
But, at least you tried. You hit the enthusiasm. Another guy is Foridis. The young man who is in Greece. He's been in Greece now for 15 years, more than 15 years. Still, he doesn't speak any Greek.
He does permaculture over in Greece.
You see?
From the family of Jules.
You know the Foridis family?
Who?
Foridis family.
No, I don't.
You must know. what was the shop called? They had a jewelry shop in Manuka. And they had a jewelry shop in Papadon.
The Bezos family. I didn't know the Bezos jewelry.
Not the Bezos. Bezos was of the younger generation.
You're thinking of taking him out?
No, fade him out.
Fade, yes.
Just go to fade after he says Allah.
Yeah,
fade out. I don't know what he says, but
yeah.
He's knowledge in the Canberra Greek community.
Yeah.
So, what's your reaction?
I think it's very good. Really, it's, I mean, what can, I'll tell you something. I told you what happened when I went and had my eye, the laser, how I felt after I walked out of the surgery, of the clinic, whatever.
I've forgotten, tell me again. How did you feel?
I felt that I was reborn. So now, I feel like rediscovering myself. You see, that's why I said last night, if I go and see the CEO, Ian Cameron, and he said, Michael, would you like to work for us again? Of course I would say yes straight away. You know what I mean?
But you wouldn't ask him.
Huh?
You would not, yesterday, you were going to ask him.
Yes.
He was going to ask you. You were going to.
Yes,
him
I will ask him.
I want a job.
Well,
I want my old
I
job.
I will ask him, of course. How can I ask him if I know that I'm leaving tomorrow to go back to Brisbane and then less than a month later I'm going back to Greece?
Well, you can ask
him. I'm just trying to express how I feel, not what really I'm going to do.
So what do you think about Michael Kazan now?
Honestly, I feel very proud of myself.
You deserve it.
Really. I mean, when I was organizing any activity, the response of the people was overwhelming. But now, but I thought, I didn't think much of it. Well, now, being at the age I am and seeing what I've done and what I have achieved, I feel very proud and re-energized, or whatever the word is. So, really, I'm very grateful. Because of my health issues, I was thinking of canceling my trip to Canberra. I'm glad I didn't.
You would have shortchanged yourself, wouldn't you?
Sorry?
You would have shortchanged yourself.
Yes. So, you know, and it's... And the other thing I was thinking, I hope they hurry up and do the extensions, whatever they want to do. So when they finish, I'll come to the grand opening and already started thinking of what I could do then to follow up the work I was doing years before. The thing is, now another thing which worries me is this excitement and whatever. When I go back to Brisbane and then back to Greece, how I feel then. You know what I mean? My physical abilities will continue. So that I keep thinking, because thinking and planning is very important, regardless if at the end you do it or not. But the thing, you know, it gives you the desire to think, and thinking and planning is a good thing. Psychologically, anyway.
So you need something to stimulate you?
To stimulate, exactly. And I've got plenty of stimulation watching all these videos you have done.
Well, this is just the tip of the iceberg.
Yes, I know.
There's more.
Now, that's what I'm saying about the hard drives, putting it across and recording it, keeping it so it's there. I mean, earlier this morning I was saying, maybe you'll never see it.
Yes.
To me, you would be stupid if you didn't.
Yeah,
because it will inspire you to go on.
Exactly.
And it may be not go on to Canberra,
yes,
but will go on to do whatever you're doing.
Yes.
In whatever way. Like you have in the past, with the refugees.
Yes,
and
exactly.
All those things.
Yeah.
Know? I mean, just to get caught up in your physical illnesses is demoralizing, as you know.
Yeah.
I mean, if I had those issues, I would give up too.
I know, and I'm really surprised because of the way you've been treated, you haven't given up a long time ago. Mm-hmm. While you get the stimulation from the reaction of the people, but the people you want to support you, they don't.
So what do you think of Emmanuel Stefano?
Emmanuel Stefano is unique. There won't be another one, ever. And I admire him for his courage and how he can put aside the way he has been treated all those years, because it's not, I mean, banning you from the Hellenic Club and the Greek Church, it's what happened recently, but and you still continue. You ignore, how can you put aside, how can you ignore all this, you know, this treatment? I don't understand. That's why I say you're unique, not only in what you're doing and what you're achieving, but also managing to ignore all of those, all these stupid people who don't realize that by banning you, they're banning Greek culture from Canberra. It's ridiculous. I'm very angry.
Maybe they don't understand Greek culture.
They? Mm-hmm. Surely they don't. And the thing is, I mean, planning an extension of $340 million, right? And they cannot find a way of preserving what you've done, all the library. What's going to happen to it? And they don't realize that the time will come that their children and grandchildren, great-grandchildren, they want to know who they are, where they came from, why, what made them strive for to be better, to do well, etc. And they won't have any records to look back to it unless these records, your records, are preserved.
So you're saying I'm mad?
Hmm?
So you're saying I'm mad, stupid?
Well, no, I wouldn't say that. But it's just I admire you for it. Let's put it that way. I'm sure anybody else would have given up a long time ago.
So that other thing you said about being your worst student, what was that?
Sorry?
About being your worst student in Greek classes.
Yes. You see, quite often, as I said many times, people and families where their children because of their doing. Spoke reasonable Greek, etc. They always tried to put down other children or other families whose children do not speak Greek as well as their children. And the common question they were asking was, what are you? Hoping that the children would say, I'm Greek. How a child born and educated in Australia can say that I'm Greek? And the thing is, the only, to these people, in order to prove that they are Greek, they should speak Greek. But the language is good when you can, if you can speak it, if you can learn it, but it doesn't really say much as to what, how you feel deep down. And some of my students, very successful in their lives, they didn't have the ability excuse me, to learn. So that made them less Greek. Or that they appreciated their culture less. And you're the brilliant example. You tried many times to learn Greek, you couldn't. But that didn't stop you from finding ways to express your Greekness. And you didn't need the language. I mean, it's strange for somebody who has been teaching Greek practically all his life, or in Australia. I came to Australia and a week later I became a teacher to the Greek community school. And say that, no, you have to learn. No. If you can learn it, if you have the ability, if you have the knack to learning languages, because people have different talents. And learning a language is a talent, and not everybody has it. So that excludes him from being part of that particular community. And I'm sure it doesn't apply only to children of Greek extraction, of any nationality. And while I was teaching Greek to the Greek or English to Greek refugees, especially those who were approved to go to another country, I was thinking how these parents are going to react towards their children when their children start speaking the language of the country they're living in, rather than Arabic or Afghani or whatever. And how Arabic people, Syrians, etc., will compare in their comments, in their treatment of their children with regards to the language, if they will have the same mentality. You speak Greek? Oh, yes, you're Greek. You don't speak Greek? No, you're not. So, I just simply hope that they will be more open-minded.
Probably
the fact that you realize that you couldn't really learn Greek, right? That pushed you to find other ways of expressing your Greekness. And, you know, by recording everything and working so hard to put them together, edit them, etc., and make sure that you don't miss any cultural activity of the Greek community.
So that's my way of speaking Greek?
Sorry, yes.
That's my way of speaking Greek?
Yeah, of course.
No,
Okay. So we come to a time now. What are we going to do about hard drives?
Yes. So if we can minimize the cost, even though the result will not be the same and as good as, so I think we should go ahead.
So how much cost? What are you talking about?
Sorry?
So how much? Give me a budget.
Well, normally I would say I can't, but I will find a way. So, but $500?
Okay, so two hard drives.
Okay.
Okay. Now, it seems to me this is your best example of your work.
Mm.
And it's a longer story. I made it longer. Okay. Now, when you're talking, so your display, tell me about displaying the icons. How did you do that?
Sorry?
How did you display them?
I didn't know how many icons I was going to get. So I produced from books some icons in case I didn't have enough for the exhibition. And then I went downstairs where the exhibition was going to be hung, and I put them on the floor, all the icons on the floor. And then I decided what goes with what. And then I started putting them on the walls.
Take you long?
Sorry?
Did it take you long?
It took me a full day.
Full day. No, well done. Kept you.
Goodness, you were fast. That was your exercise for the day, was it?
Yep. So was this here when you were here 7 years ago?
Sorry?
Was this here?
Yeah, yes.
So what's here? Here we are. What colour do you like? Red or blue? Or black?
Makes no difference. Blue.
Blue? Okay.
You want to spend that amount of money?
No, he doesn't. At all. But, however, he's a super achiever. Aren't you?
What?
You're a super achiever, aren't you?
Yes.
Well, and you want to pass that on to his descendants.
Oh, pass on to his descendants.
So it's worth it?
Yep.
One or two?
You happy with that?
No, he's not.
Yep.
I keep reminding him, he doesn't. He's not.
So what's the difference between this and this?
What's the difference?
Do we have to go through that?
Yes.
Huh? No, we don't. I don't have time for... Yep. Beautiful. What's the guarantee on them?
I think they've got a year.
A year.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to keep the receipt?
Yes.
Okay? Because there's no guarantee it will last, okay?
I see.
Okay. The hard drives, the mechanical, okay? So how are you liking it?
Yes. But 10 years ago I went back to Greece and now I'm visiting. My son lives in Brisbane, so I'm visiting him. So coming all the way to Australia, not come to Canberra, it's not
well, I know. They think Sydney's the capital, but we are.
So what about his accent? Is it good? He's got a good accent? Yeah, not too bad. We'll give you a race back. So he's going to be first down there?
Yes.
What can I do? It doesn't work. Sorry, a bit slow, huh?
No photos, nothing.
Videos anymore.
I'd still take photos.
Yeah, take photo to me. No, you don't need to me because you're like a spy to me, like Russia. After you send me back to Russia there.
No, I'm the taxation office.
Okay, thank you very much.
Our daughter in England does gin as well, doesn't she? And next step into the shop, tell your daughter, look at this, we're in Ainslie at the moment. Give us an introduction.
Hi, Anita and Dom, we're in Ainslie. And look at this. Know, what a range.
Exactly. What a beautiful display, isn't it? Coffee and liqueur. Excuse me, Mrs. Kazan, coming through. Beautiful.
Yes.
And little takeaways here. Takeaway bottles.
And Canberra gin.
Yes. Canberra gin as well.
Winter gin.
Is this gin over here? Vodka. That's a beautiful display, isn't it?
Mm.
I like the little square cubicles.
Yeah.
So where's the... What do you think?
It's really a history in itself. I mean, starting 1945 and then they took over in 63.
Beautiful story, isn't it?
Yes. Sure.
And tucked away, we joined ShopRite in 1975.
Way down here.
This is now the supermarket. More important than the sales in the story.
Anu.
Don't worry for the money, I give free for you.
Free?
Because you're a young man, you know.
I come back here.
Can you stop the lid?
Έχω περίπου 20 boxes. Before you have 200.
Yeah.
After I go all, no more.
Of course.
84
years old. How much? 84. Yeah, you've got 1 year.
I've got 83.
I don't know how to remember that much. I was a teacher at the Ελληνικό Σχολείο, in Λέσχη. I did exhibitions, συναυλίες. Είχα μια φορά μια καφετερία στο Σίβι, σε Ζάμ. Κόψω δίπλα στο αυτό, δίπλα στο...
What's the bus depot in Σίβι?
Jollibon Center. Δίπλα στο Jollibon Center. Εγώ σε θυμάμαι. Εγώ σε γνώρισα αμέσως.
Ναι, αλλά το μυαλό μου ξέρεις πολλά φορά, δεν δουλεύει καλά γάμο.
Τι να κάνουμε.
Ξεχνάω,
μπορούμε
ξεχνάω.
Να κάνουμε τι.
Αφού park my car here, I'll look my car on other side. After the black said to me, now maybe you never come with a car, you come with a bus. I said, what are you talking about? I come with my car, not with a bus. I look my car. I park here, I look on other side. Say, now my, sometimes I go in the Monaco one day, half, 2 hours, look for my car. Lady said to me, you sure you drive the car or you come with the bus? What are you talking about? I come with the car, not with the bus. Doesn't work proper. First, lose the
what
screw.
What can we do?
Τι να κάνουμε. Το όνομά σου είναι?
Μιχάλης.
Αλέκος, ένα γόλ.
Ναι. Γερός και Σιδηρένιος.
Οκ. See
you. Thank you for the honey.
Γεια σου Μανώλη, τι κάνεις, καλά είσαι.
Καλώς όρισες.
Ευχαριστώ.
Και φίλης.
Γεια σου Γιώργη.
How are you? Good. That's good. That's good. How are you?
Very good.
That's good.
How are you going?
Hello.
I'm running around like an idiot.
Good to see you.
As usual. Hi.
Yeah. Hi, hello.
Look who I found
George
on the
Sarris?
Street. Look who I found. Look who I found.
How many years since you've been here?
You mean in as a shop?
No, that's right. Right, in shops, yeah, all right.
40 years. But no, I came 7 years ago.
Okay.
I've been away for 10, just over 10 years. now.
Yeah.
And my son lives in Brisbane.
Okay.
So I come to see him.
Let's go have a cup of coffee.
And then I couldn't come to Australia, not come to Canberra.
Yeah.
I came last Monday.
Yeah.
And I'm living tomorrow.
Tim Ksarakis told me you were coming.
Yes.
Yeah.
So at times I feel that I never left Canberra.
Yeah.
Even though I can't believe the
changes.
The changes, the development, things like that. So it was the first house I could rent in when I came to Canberra in 1970. It was in Hargreaves Crescent in Ainsley.
Oh, just
here. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. You went,
wow.
Manuel said, did you used to come here for shopping? I said, I don't remember. But when I walked in, then I got a room, because the cashier was there,
yeah.
Always, yes? Yes, it's not been moved.
Oh, yeah, it's always been in the front here.
Yeah.
Yes.
So
a few more cash registers these days.
And you look well, Manoli.
Oh, thank you very, thank you very much, yes. Michael. I had a little bit to do with Michael when I was president of the Hellenic
really
Club.
Yeah, yes.
It was
the, that period,
yeah,
I remember.
Yeah, 1999, 2001, and we got the cultural side of the Hellenic Club set up.
So you introduced that, did you?
Yeah. Yeah, with Michael, yeah, that's when we introduced while I was the president.
Yes.
We got that happening there.
Yeah, so how did you get the Greeks to talk about culture?
Huh? I wonder why.
Did you twist their arm at all?
No, not at all. They embraced it.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's go have a cup of coffee.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. George, come and join us.
I'll drop by for a coffee.
Okay, yeah.
So the Walton must in a lab affinity for the we came so close to seeing each other in his township near
So you've known each other for a while?
Oh, yes. 20 years?
Yeah.
20?
Excuse me, director.
Yeah,
my name is Neil.
And then in 26 ora in Mehali,
Probably it took you a while to get used to the idea.
So tell me about Mr. Kazan.
Oh, well, he's an amazing man. He's always inspired me and my daughters. Well, Eleni, my eldest son. I mean, I used to do Greek dancing and I was very involved and supported Michael. In fact, we had that exhibition, remember?
The photographic exhibition.
With three.
You, Eleni,
and Jim.
Dimitris.
Yes. So there was someone from the photographer from the National Library, photographer from the National Gallery, and the photographer, me, from the National Museum. Three photographers, and we had a photographic exhibition open up to the Greek community. With a bit of prize
money.
The students from your class.
Yeah, the students, yes. That's the photographs were submitted from the students of the Greek classes.
Yes, that's right. Yes. And it was like in a cultural, you know, sort of photographic exhibition.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's been good knowing you?
Most certainly. Mm-hmm. And Michael's been good value and still continues to be. Yeah. Yeah, you're very much loved. No, it's good.
Actually, you must admit that the welcome I received was unbelievable.
Yeah.
And it comes from Ian.
What are we drinking? So I'll order it. What are we drinking?
I'm drinking a small flat white.
Frappuccino.
flat white, three quarters full. So not
small flat white, three quarters full.
Yes.
Annette?
Skinny decaffeinated.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I know that.
So you find that to come with
all the right, right, now, well, Mango, what do you? You want extra hot what?
Water.
Extra hot water.
Just water.
Just water. Yeah. Water's easy.
Flat George? White for me, normal flat white.
Flat white, decaffeinated flat white?
No.
Oh, not decaffeinated, cappuccino.
Decaffeinated small
cappuccino. And I'll have to ask for Michael's again.
So what was your order?
Sorry, we're having coffee with Manuel Celaya from Los Angeles.
Michael, yours was again?
A flat white, small flat white, 3/4 full.
Right. Decaf.
Decaf, skim milk, cappuccino.
Decaf, skim milk, cappuccino.
Yeah.
And George was?
Flat white.
Flat white.
Flat white.
Flat white. Yes.
Michael taught him Greek, and he was a real, you know, he loved Greek culture, Greek people, and he ended up going, walking from one part of Crete to the other, all across the mountains, like 300 kilometers.
Wow.
And very good friend of Ian.
Actually, I had lunch with him yesterday.
Yeah.
And today were another five, six students from the same class.
Oh, very good. Really nice. So you've got legacy.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Greek is very good, man.
Sorry?
And I thought to myself, look, you go there only for 1 week or 2 weeks in summer, because they all had business.
Yeah.
So why you spend so much money in a house? Why don't you go and stay in a hotel and comfort, etc., etc., than investing a lot of money? And that's why I ask you, do you go off and do...
We had a house we bought in 1981 in Batemans Bay.
Yeah.
When my father passed away in 86, my father used to go all the time, so we had good use for the house. When he died in 86, as you said, you go for 1 week, or 2 weeks maybe, wash towels, wash, change the benches, do everything else. So in 91, I said to the family, I want to sell my house. Do you want to buy the house from me? Because it was my house, I was paying it off, it was my house. No. And I thought, because it was costing me $4,000 every year, rates, insurance, maintenance, whatever. And then once I sold it, then $4,000, I discovered Australia. Oh, you go to Port Douglas, or you go to Cairns, or you go to Coffs Harbour, and you discovered Australia. And you go to a nice resort for 10 days, all the towels change, all the bed sheets change, and you live it up.
Exactly.
And there was like $4,000.
Awesome. Thank you. 3/4 full flat white.
Thank you.
Mocha?
Yes, thank you.
Can I have some more sugar?
Pardon?
Can I have some more sugar? Another four.
Yep. Another four?
Four.
Alicia.
My story.
Alicia. Well then.
Yes. Well, look, George, I was born during the war.
You need to.
There was no sugar then. So I'm making
enough money. Okay. I'll accept that, Ricardo. I'll accept that.
It's beautiful.
When do you go back to Greece?
I'm leaving tomorrow. I can go back to Brisbane, my son. And I'm leaving Brisbane on the 4th of June.
Okay.
So I'm staying here for another month. 10 weeks altogether.
It's crazy.
You know, I wanted to come.
How many tacos have you had?
$7.
Thank you. We all gave him some sugar, so much for all of them. Thank you.
So when I go to cafeteria,
and I take the coffee, it's spicy, guys, so
yeah. And then what I do, I cover it with, well, because I'm too embarrassed, so I cover it with and then the empty one, I put in my pocket.
Yeah. You want to serve.
And how long have you been in Canberra?
Since last Monday.
Okay. Same with you?
Yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
good.
So I've seen this a few times.
Yeah. Stop looking.
No.
When I come in on a Sunday morning, early Sunday mornings, I waste my coffee for all the stuff. So 15 coffees, you know what? I bought them on a Sunday morning.
Yeah.
And one lady in a daily issue, Indian lady, but she wants a lot of coffee. I said, sorry, I'm only going to get you two coffees. I just get you two macros. You can't have more than two coffees. So she's getting used to it now. Two sugars. Two sugar. Because she wants a lot of sugar. No, maximum two. I won't get sugar.
So you get the coffees for me?
Yeah, I do it Sunday morning when I come in. And I didn't do a few Sundays, then I did five Sundays in a row. So, you know, it costs me $60 every time, whatever it is. But I do it for them on Sunday morning. And I'm working this Sunday morning, so they're going to be happy. One of the guys said to me the other day, Mango, we miss you on a Sunday morning. So you miss me or you miss the coffee? And of course, I laughed.
That's right, exactly.
So whereabouts in Greece do you live?
In Athens.
Marcusa is...
Well, it's your father. Your father. Vulagmeni, Vulagmeni, Vulagmeni.
Okay.
It's what they call now the Athens Rivieram. But in Vulagmeni, you see some beautiful and enormous villas.
Yeah.
But Vulagmeni itself, apart from two good fish restaurants, nothing else.
Oh, really?
Because the people got the money, they've got to give father.
Yeah.
For coffee, for dinner, whatever, they've got to give father. They're not staying in when people ask me, where do you live in America? I said, I live in America. It's so quiet.
Nice.
So did you buy a bank of us?
Did I buy? My father built it. My parents built it in 86. Now my father, I'll tell you a big story. In 85, he wanted to buy a house. He borrowed $100,000 from here, I think it was about 14%, to build the house on the island, in the village. And I said, Dad, you know, I'm 30 years old. So why the hell are you doing that for? If you're going to borrow $100,000, a lot of money back then. Do something here.
Yeah.
He goes, no. And I'll say it in Greek first. I want to build some there that will draw you back to your roots. Right? And I didn't understand what you're talking about. Then he built the house in 85 through 86 and didn't get to live. He died in 86. He didn't get to live in it. So, yeah. And you know, it's a big house, right? At the end of the village. Four huge bedrooms, bathroom, kitchen, everything. And it was ultra modern, big, beautiful house. And then I went in 1990 I was just newly married with two little girls. You know, we stayed in this big, beautiful house. I thought, yeah, it was good. We were there for 5-6 weeks. Then I didn't go for 15 years.
Yeah.
2005, when my daughter Alicia, she went for the ballet competition in London.
You said yes, 100%.
I said, we can go to London, we'll go to Greece. Again, we stayed 5-6 weeks. Beautiful house. I didn't mean it. Right, I was happy that, you know, didn't pay for accommodation. Then my daughter went to study in London for her dance. So she went, and my mother would go to Greece every year. So Alicia would go and stay with my mother in Karpathos. So Alicia was 2005, 2006, 2007, and 2008 when she graduated, we went back again for graduation. And instead of saying, Miss Auntie Michael, here's my daughter Alicia, she said, Baba, this is Michael, Baba, this is Maggie. And she knew everybody in the village. And they all laughed and they considered her as she'd be ballerina, myself, the ballerina. And then one day my mother said to me, I get emotional when I say it. My mother said to me, when you go to Bulgaria to the capital, go to the post office for me and do this. And I went to Bulgaria, where the hell is the post office? And Alicia said, Baba, just come down here, there, and she knew it. And that's when it hit me, when my father said in 1985, and I understood it in 2008.
Yeah,
I want to build something that will draw you to your roots. Because I realized Alicia was drawn to her roots.
You see, the same happened now with my son Theo.
Yeah.
because I've got a very big apartment in and I said, thank you. Look, I think you're coming back to Australia. But my, I get two sisters in the same brother. My sister's passed away. So you live here. I mean, how often do you go? He came last year only for 5 days.
Yeah.
So, you know, that, no. We want to have something from you in Greece.
It's good.
I see.
So now you're going over here.
Well, see, this was 2008. 2010, Alicia says, when are we going to go to Greece again? Not Greece, Athens. So I said, I'm going. She came with me in 2010. 2012.
How old is she at this stage?
15, 17, 19, 1988. So, then in 2012, we're having a big cook-up at my sister Yvonne's house. She renovated the kitchen. And it was a Mexican night, so everybody's cooking different Mexican food. And Mum says, I'm going to go to Greece, you know. I want somebody to come with me. Well, she's not going to come with me. They'll do it. And Mum says, Mum, no, I'm not going to come. I've got this. I said, Mum, I was there 2 years ago. I think I'll come this year. I said, Yvonne, you have been 24 years. You go, no, but my daughter's going to give birth in a few months' time, or in October. And I said, then, you know, after a few more sangrias and a bit of food and drink, I said, you know what, Mum's never been there because you always try to be there around Panagias, 15th of August. And I said, Mum's never been there for Panagias with her three children together. In 12 days, we all had our tickets. No excuse, I can't this, I can't that. And I said, Lucia, she goes, of course I'm coming. Yvonne brought her granddaughter Anthea as well. And my was more proud to see my mother through the church, but three children, and granddaughters, cousins, you know, and a beautiful face.
She passed away
3 years ago now.
3 years.
Yeah. And then Alicia says to me, oh, Mama, I want to start going somewhere else. It was about this time in 2014. I said, Alicia, I think it's going to Greece. You want to come? Of course. She did come 16, but then she came in 18, just before she got married with her fiancé. That's that quite a while. Later on that year, she got married in September. And, you know, when Jordan's making a speech, he said, oh, we're not going to go on a honeymoon right now. We've actually already been on a honeymoon with my father-in-law. You know? And he says, but I couldn't keep up with you. We'd go home at midnight. And then all of a sudden, Bangle says, see you later. And I'd go home at 5 o'clock in the morning. So I'd go over where all my mates were and a few more drinks. And then there's the kids. What kind of work, you know, because something was going on in the village. And then, of course, you had COVID. And in 22, and actually came again, I went in 22.
And I was like, holy fuck.
She came over with her husband. Little baby, she came over last week. And they're living in Portugal right now.
With no pressure, there's something about the capacities.
You haven't left the house, decided to renovate the house. Originally, just because my father put carpet in. You don't want carpet in carpet. But it was a big job. And while we're doing that, you know what? This is the main bathroom, another toilet, another ensuite. Knock out the wall. So it was a huge, and I found a really good builder. People say, they'll rip you off. Of course, you pay a little bit extra. But every week was laid in the green out, video inside the house, showing me what was going on. And they did an amazing job. So it's a brand new green house. So, you know, I'm 6 and 9 this year. So I want to start. Going more often. I don't want to go when I'm 90 years old.
Enjoy it now.
And Alicia's pregnant, so she was here for my young daughter, just got married 3 weeks ago.
Because he's like,
and I've just gone back to Portugal, so my plan is to go to Portugal.
10 days ago, couple, 1 week, and then go back and shoot.
It's one of those things where it's like
I built a new house, the termites, and it's been 2 years now. The end of the month I'm with him, and Robert, who's the builder, they did an amazing job. He's a perfectionist. And can you pay a bit more? But there's no cracks, there's no nothing, you know, everything is to the team. And he wants to do, basically for his online portfolio, you know, like 2 years after he has your tickets. So I keep on telling him, Rob, I just love my house. So he's got a way to come and do just a little story.
Yeah, right, right. That is the ultimate.
Because like, it's a huge house, it's just a good size house. You know, you've been doing it.
Yeah,
and it's just
good layout. Yeah.
Nice. And you sit on the back veranda, and you can sit through the family room.
Yeah, sure. Lost some more?
Maybe it did.
All right. Fancy Bravo all together, looking straight. Thank you.
For the
course.
There is absolutely no way. Did you know?
Hello, look at this.
There's no way.
It's your professional. Michael.
Yeah, that's great. Lovely. Looking at that view.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I can fucking eat that shit.
Thank you.
Her parents were high in
town,
wasn't it?
She
was loaded.
Yeah, Lenny Moore.
Yes.
Yeah, sure.
I'll take it.
She wanted to see you, but she's working.
Yeah,
Lenny, but she. I thought if I could just fail.
And I'll do one for you, George.
Thank you. All right, good. I've got your Greek number as well.
What have we got here?
What are you spraying the food with?
Kazan, here's to the new Mr. Kazan.
Cheers.
Cheers, huh?
Cheers.
May you awaken many other people.
Yes, and I order you. You visit Greece this year or next year.
From here?
From here, yes.
From here?
Huh?
From here, I haven't left.
No, to come
Greece
to Greece.
Is with me everywhere I go.
Yeah.
Don't you know
that's
that?
That's true.
Don't you understand that?
Yes, I do.
How many years I've been trying to teach you this and you haven't grasped it, have you? Is a physical place.
To be physically in Greece, mentally.
You think Greece is a physical place, it's not.
Yeah.
Didn't you hear your mother and your father?
Yes.
Well,
exactly. Oh, really, it's brilliant. I mean, whatever you do, Emmanuel, so it's nice to have a record of, I really enjoy my stay in Canberra, and as I said, I feel reborn, revitalized, I don't think of my age anymore.
So let's go and do some Turkish.
Okay, cool, why not?
You were descended from Turks, weren't you, way back?
Yes, both my parents were born in Turkey, of Greek parents.
Well, in Australia today, we'd say they're both born Turkish.
As
Turks, you know.
I won't go that far. I don't think my parents would be happy.
No, it wouldn't be at all.
Hearing that.
Too much pain and suffering.
Yes. Sorry?
Too much pain and suffering and
of course,
karma.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Fancy seeing you. Ella, you coming in there?
Yes.
Up a door. You know where to go. Keep coming in.
Yes.
You know where you're sitting? What?
What is he doing here? So I was imagining things then. This is what I'm looking for.
So, did you come in here this morning?
Yes.
So you brought it down with you?
And probably you brought it down without you.
So, what will you call him? Silly Duffer? What's Silly Duffer in Greek?
Silly Duffer? Vlaka.
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 Vlaka Stoyalo. Is that the song?
I don't have to rub it in.
Give me a special bag too. I never get a special bag with this. Yep. Has it got your name on the back? No, no name on the back. He liked it, huh?
Yes.
He liked it, huh? It was nice.
So with this, it's 52.30.
Okay. One multigrain.
Multigrain? Slice or unslice?
Sorry?
Slice or unslice?
Unslice?
Mm-hmm.
One resin.
Orange and raisin? Unsliced, yes. As well? Unsliced, all unsliced?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And 2 almond croissants.
And one house sourdough for me.
Are you guys paying together?
He's going to pay for me.
Oh, wow.
I'm being treated. This is my father.
Oh, but he looks so young.
I have to express my thanks to the CEO, Ian Cameron. Every time I wanted to organize something, I went to him and I said, oh, Ian, this is what I want to do. So Ian would say to me with a smile, go ahead, Michael, be careful of your budget. So you never asked how much it was going to cost, but be careful. And she knew that I was not going to be a spendthrift. And so when, for example, we needed to frame things, I will go and look around and find the cheapest, the best and the cheapest frames, for example, things like that. Yes. That's why I said before that I did what I did from my part, but also I wouldn't have been able to do all these things unless I had the support of the Hellenic Club. If I may refer to a letter that I received from Andrew Sessions after I left, thanking me for all I did for the Hellenic Club. And he said in his letter, Marco, when you came to us and talked to what you were planning, we really couldn't understand what you were talking about. But we're glad that we did give you the job and we asked you to be part of the development, if you like, of the Hellenic Club. So yes, I did get the support of the board. And also the fact that my position was kept open for 3 years in case you decide to come back.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So.
Okay. So. What was your reaction after seeing that?
I want to see it again and again.
Good. Good.
To be honest, I'm surprised myself. I mean,
surprised what about yourself?
Sorry?
Surprised in what about? What were you surprised about yourself?
what I've done, really, as I've said many times, I was enjoying what I was doing and the people showed the appreciation, but now looking at these videos and also meeting all these people, the way how warmly they welcome back and talk to me and things like that, I feel very proud. I feel that I left a legacy, in all humility. Yes.
I got a comment on that video by an 11-year-old, a 10-year-old, 11-year-old, saying that you're a great man.
I won't go that far. That was very kind of whoever put this.
That's not the point. That's not the point. The point is he moved. He was moved.
I feel that touched a lot of people. And now I'm touched by their comments.
Yeah. So what I've got, so that's a tip of the iceberg. That's two tips of the iceberg. I've still got the rest of it to do. Now, at the moment, you invested in two hard drives.
Yes.
One you'll take away with you, and I'm still adding files to that now.
Right.
I'm adding now the files, the spirit of us, all the variations of that.
Yeah, yeah.
On there, right? I don't know why, but at least you've got the full story there. Now, with hopefully you'll come to see it, the hard drive, because there's a wealth of information.
Yeah.
Now, I wasn't too careful about what was on and what was not on. I just grabbed things and copied.
Yeah.
So 4 or 5 hours copy. 4 or 5 hours copy. So when you arrived in Canberra, it was in 2000, wasn't it? Sorry, the Hellenic Club.
The Hellenic Club, I started working, yes, in January 2000.
January 2000. And you finished?
And I left at the end of November 2013.
2013. Okay. Because they're the files that I want to copy because I'm sure I've got to cross it. Before you leave, but also I'll keep adding to it on the other hard drive.
Okay? Yeah, I know.
Now, this has taken me so far over a week.
Since I know. You've been here, right? That's what I was thinking before.
Day and night.
Yes.
Okay? Now, I kept asking myself yesterday, why am I doing it? And I never got an answer.
Sorry?
I kept asking myself, why am I doing it?
Yes.
Why am I pushing myself to do this? Why don't I just sit back and relax? Why don't I get out in the garden?
Okay. I think it is, yes, I did what I did, but you did an equally important job in recording these things. And the thing is, I feel very grateful to you because I'm going to leave something for my children, which is very important for me. I separated and got divorced when my children were very, very young, right? I never stopped having contact with them and supporting them as much as I could. But this is the best thing I could leave for them. That's how I feel. That's what I think. And the thing is, as I said before, I'm proud of what I've done and what I have achieved. But you should even more proud of your work, because what I did, would have gone forever unless we didn't have your records. And I will say it again and again. I'm so angry the way people treated you and refused support.
It's a bit like It's a bit like you know who.
Yeah. I mean,
the main artist.
I have forgotten what I've done. And things I did. Right? And I feel rejuvenated. yes, I said before. I feel I'm reborn. I don't feel my age. Something I never thought would ever happen to me.
You mentioned about leaving for your children. What are you leaving? Do you think they're going to watch this?
Leaving my effort to promote Greek culture, not only to people of Greek origin, but to the wider community. Yes, I mean, you know, because my children love me, right? I know, and appreciate what I've done for them. But I want them to know what I did for the wider community, for my culture, for my heritage. Also, I did what I did because of also of my upbringing, and that's even though my parents are not around to see this, but I'm sure from up there they'll know what I'm doing, and I'm sure they will feel very proud of me and probably very proud of themselves that they brought me the way they brought me up. So, what more can I say?
They still with you?
Sorry?
Are your parents still with you?
Yes, of course, I'm sure.
I think they're helping you too. Still from up there.
Sorry?
If they can, I'm sure they're helping you from up there.
Yes.
Giving you encouragement. Oh, no. You're getting it from somewhere.
And the thing is, I mean, your parents will feel equally proud of you.
Yeah.
Even though how long has your parents passed away?
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, but
they haven't passed, right?
Yes, and
they're still with me.
Yes, of course, exactly.
I see them all the time on
exactly
video.
Exactly. So
they're not away.
I think we both should be grateful for meeting each other, working together, and producing something that will stay forever.
Yeah,
and be appreciated. But don't forget, I mean, let's take Theophilus. Nobody appreciated Theophilus apart from the people who asked him to paint in their houses or in their coffee shops or whatever. Right? But Theophilus was appreciated more and most after he passed away.
Yeah. And they didn't have video in those days.
Sorry?
They didn't have video in those days.
Yeah.
These paintings.
Exactly. And, I mean, I remember the exhibition, right? But now, listening to the comments of the people who attended the exhibition, it's something that I didn't realize at the time, to be honest.
Yeah.
And now, you know, all these comments, so complimentary for my work, but also for the exhibition. For the club giving me the opportunity to do that.
Now, there is a longer version of that on YouTube.
Yes.
Okay? Like there's longer versions of other things on YouTube.
Yeah.
So when you go exploring, that we started there, just keep going through, you know, slowly, slowly go through it, have a look, and it'll refresh you on things that happened back then, but also your legacy today.
Yes.
I mean, nothing to do with you today, you won't see Michael Kazan there, but for example, the Greek dancing.
Yes.
That's you there. But your effect, your legacy.
The thing was that shortly after I arrived, it was the time that the youth club was formed. And I taught them Greek dancing.
Is that right?
And we had performances at, what do we call that building next to the Hyatt?
Albert Hall.
Yes, in Albert Hall.
So that was where the classes were, or that's where the
that's right.
When I was, the performances were.
Yes. So when I was teaching Greek, the Greek school, for the 25th, actually no, it was the 28th of October, I don't remember even the year, we had a performance, school performance, at the, not the Canberra Theatre, what, the Playhouse. Which other community had done that?
So you did that?
Yes.
With whom?
Sorry?
With whom?
With the other teachers.
Aleka, was she involved?
Sorry?
Was Aleka involved?
Aleka?
Yeah, Aleka.
No, no, no. It was very early in the piece when I started, probably 72, 73.
Really?
Yes, and you know, a small community, the Greek community, because we're not really, we're a minority, to be able to hire and stage a performance in the Playhouse.
So 1973.
And the thing is, I had written the, what's the word, how, what was going, I directed it, I made the scenery, I designed the costumes for the children. I still have one or two photos from that performance.
And how long did you do that for? How many years did you do that?
I was teaching there for about, at the Greek Community School, about 3 years. And then, because I didn't get the support I was hoping to get, and I needed to do what I wanted to do, I started teaching Greek to children in the Witangera Primary School. At the time I was living in Witangera. And I will never forget, there was one of my students was doing ballet and she was doing extremely well. So I gave her a piece of Greek music and I asked her to dance to it. And I remember the educational, well, the person who was responsible for the education of children in Australia at the Greek embassy had come to the performance. Some people, especially the ones from the Greek community, were the board of the Greek community were against me because they thought that I was going against the Greek community. I was not. But as they couldn't see what I was driving at and what I wanted to do, and I didn't get the support, that forced me to start a school with Tangere. The children were coming for free. I didn't get any money for it, for all the work. And, you know, the number of students kept increasing and increasing and increasing. Then I introduced modern Greek at the Center for Continuing Education, at ANU. A lot of people had come to my classes there. And that was long before I started working at the Hellenic Lab.
So how many students have you had?
Probably about 30, I would think. You're talking about the primary school teaching or the Center for Continuing Education? Well, at the Center for Continuing Education, I would have had approximately about 30 students. And the thing was that most of them, yes, were of Greek background, but there were people from other nationalities as well. And I remember one of my students went to Greece for a holiday. And when she came back, I asked her, can you tell me what you think of the Greeks? I mean, how do you enjoy your stay there? But especially, what do you think about the Greek character? And her response, which I still remember, was, if you go to a Greek home and you've got only one loaf of bread, they will give you more than half of it.
Beautiful.
So their generosity, their friendship, their hospitality.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready. Yes.
You want a cigarette first?
No, just... Razor.
Orange razor?
Yeah, one raisin and one multigrain. And two almond croissants.
This one's the almond one down here. Take me down.
Sorry?
Thank you. Let's go, baby.
Beautiful, huh?
Yeah.
Hello.
So, back to when you come here, this is a flying school, right? So, you can cook, right? You can do a demonstration, you've got a favourite recipe.
Exactly, because you see, the thing is, because you said...
Don't give me excuses, just listen. So you can...
Annette doesn't cook. Well, I was going to offer, I mean, to cook something for you while I'm here. What I'm doing...
You're for a talk.
Yes.
You don't do
talk.
I
can cook and talk at the same time.
Well, prove it, you know?
Yeah.
So, as I was saying, it could be a recipe you want to pass on.
Yes.
Video-wise.
Hmm.
Okay. One of your favourite recipes that you think should outlive you. It's given you joy over the years. And you can say, okay, I'm going to cook.
Yes, that's what you've offered.
Whatever it is. Doesn't matter who
so
it is.
So, I promise next time I will wear my working hat. I do the cooking.
No, I'm not asking you to do the cooking. I'm not asking you to do the cooking.
Yeah.
I'm asking you to do.
Yes.
The gardener's welcoming you.
Yes. I would love to do, that's for sure. I would love to work in the garden.
You know, anything, you know. But not just sitting. Okay, because city, you just, as I said, it's not a retirement village.
Something else I wanted.
So when you go back...
Do you know that this Lucadelis, whatever his name is, he pushed Consulias in the church?
He pushed him?
Yes.
What do you mean he pushed him? Shoved him?
You hear an argument?
When was that?
Huh?
When?
I don't remember exactly, we didn't talk about it. And I said to the boys, I said, didn't he slap them? You slapped him? I mean, if anybody pushes me...
You push back?
Of course I will.
And what did Con do?
I don't know. I said, how he reacted? He said, oh, he didn't, you know, but don't talk to consulates about Locadelis or whatever. Yeah, yeah. Locadelis.
With a vengeance.
Yeah. He's such a bastard.
Yeah.
I mean, looking at him, you can tell he's not a nice character.
Yeah.
And what did you do after you came back? Did you go out for dinner or you stayed home?
We stayed home.
Oh, I stayed home.
We stayed. We're not like you.
Oh, sorry?
We're not like you.
No.
Flying, we were out there gallivanting around. It was good, beautiful. No wonder you're exhausted, you know. However, nonetheless.
Oh, also the Ajepa had a meeting last night, I knew that.
So you're going to say hello?
In the Delphi room. So there were a couple of ladies there, I went and talked to them. So, yeah.
Well, I got the other video up.
Yeah.
Okay, so
I saw the message and the thing.
And as well as copy all the files, not yes. All the files, but I think the hard drive is maybe three quarters full the files, which is enough for you to take away with you.
Yep.
And I've backed it up overnight. So I got up at 3 o'clock in this morning and backed them up on the second hard drive. So I've got a mirror image of the one you've taken away. So I now know what you've got.
Yes.
Okay? So I'll slowly add other things, okay?
Yeah.
So the next step is to finish that video off, or your interview off, and I don't know how or when. I did check 3 o'clock this morning. Anyone has seen the video?
Yeah.
Not many people have, but I did get a comment on one of them.
Yep.
And the comment said, a great man.
Honestly, the compliments I've got from everybody.
What have you got?
There was nobody who just looked at me and, wow, what he's doing here. You know what I mean?
So
because there were some people who were against me for some reason.
Can't understand why.
Jealousy or whatever it was. But this time...
So what did they say? Or have you forgotten?
Oh, nice to see you and, you know, are you going to stay in Greece or are you going to come back to Australia? That surprised me, that question. I said, oh, no, well, I'm seriously thinking of returning. Are you going to come back? I said, no, I'll go where my son is. But of course, I will visit Canberra as often as I can.
So what were the nice things they said about you?
Sorry?
What were the nice things they said about you?
Oh, you did a great job. That's
it?
Yes.
Just one thing, you did a great job.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we miss you and also what... Father Petro said, I don't know if it's the thing, he said, look, since you left, why do we call it Hellenic Club? What's Hellenic about it? The only thing they care is money.
I tried to get him to say it on the camera, but he wouldn't. Thank you, you've just done it.
Yeah. I didn't engage in long conversations, apart from when I was having dinner with the Descarolysis and
other people, etc. So, because when Theo was making the booking for me to come to Canberra, he said, "Dad, how long do you want to stay?" I said, 3-4 days will be plenty. He said, "Dad, you're going all the way to Canberra for 3 days. You regret." Now, I feel like the time went so quickly.
Non-stop. So have you enjoyed flying while you're in Canberra?
You have
enjoyed flying. You've been flying in Canberra.
Yes.
You've been flapping your wings.
Oh, yes, 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 yes.
Have you enjoyed
flapping your wings? I'm glad I came. Yes, I did. I did.
So after you take off today on the plane,
yes,
and you land in Brisbane, are you going to still flap or are you going to sit down and smoke cigarettes, drink coffee?
I will think of Canberra for a long time. Not only when I go back to Brisbane, but also when I go back to Greece. Canberra and my visit to Canberra, and especially being with you, it will stay with me for a long time. I can assure you.
Good.
You know, it's... I can't really... I feel that I've got energy now. I don't know why. You know what I mean? Yeah. Started thinking and...
Bravo.
You see? Yeah. It's...
Being reborn.
Yes, reborn. That's the word I wanted to use, but then I thought probably is, you know. Yeah. It's the way I felt after the laser treatment. I feel similar, there are similar feelings now of me being in Canberra.
Explain, I don't understand. After the laser treatment.
I want to do things.
Yeah.
You know?
So what are you going to do?
Sorry?
What are you going to do?
Well, the thing is, what worries me is how long will take this stupid extension going to take. But already thought two things. One of the banks in Greece have a brilliant collection of touristy posters done by well-known artists in Greece. And I almost had organized to bring the exhibition
Excellent.
Here. Beautiful. That was one thing.
Yeah.
The other thing is that monologue of about somebody being Theophilos and talking about his thoughts and things like that. It's only one man show. It's a short one, it's about an hour. Easy to, they donate even to, well, I mean the scenery, whatever you call it. It's minimal, so it will not be hard or expensive to move, to bring here. And the other thing I was thinking, a concert.
They're big, thinking big, aren't you?
Well,
that's beautiful. Well, you've got some great connections.
And also, get all these people, I mean, even bring the girl who is in, because she was in the, she was singing, all right, from Mytilene to here for this instance. Just, again, one person.
Yeah. Easy to arrange. With your connections, is what I'm getting.
Yes.
It's your connections.
Because I want, yes, to reunion, and, you know, what people did 20 years earlier.
Yeah.
I'm sure Mr. Cameron will be open to it, and I'm sure he'll take it to the board, and I think hopefully the board will see the latest video.
Honestly, but why they did that? I mean, I don't understand. What was the reason behind it?
No, doesn't matter what the reason is. As I said, hopefully they'll see the latest video and they'll say, Mr. Kazan was fantastic.
Yes.
And when they get a submission from Ian to say, should we support this new venture? Should we bring all these posters from Greece or bring these artists from Greece? I think they'll say yeah. Because there's a need there.
But what's and also, missing, you know, the other thing
what's
is...
What's been missing is that someone pushing it
yes.
from there or here to be pushing it. And
because also, I want to do something about your work somehow.
Well, you have.
And your contribution, huh?
You have. Where did you see the video? Have you seen the video yet?
No. Yeah. But I know now what you're doing and...
Yeah, but okay, see the video.
I don't have to...
Now have a look at it. You know, you got your coffee, you had your cigarette, now have a look at it. And I'll go back to doing...
I'll have another cigarette, sorry.
Yeah, have another cigarette.
To wake up.
Sorry, you were saying?
I said that this is for the first time I don't feel my age.
So how do you feel?
I feel like what it was 10 years ago. You know, it's really incredible.
Except,
well, the reality will come, right? You know, when I walk and things like that.
So what are you going to do about that?
Well, I'll try to be more energetic and
what?
Walk and do something and look after my health.
And how do you do that?
As much as I can.
How do you do that?
Thinking, planning.
Asking?
Asking what?
Asking for help.
Help with physical things, yes. Yeah.
Well, how do I... To me, if you're in a situation here, you're downhill, okay?
Yeah.
You're going to lose it, everything, right? Unless you stand up and you say, no, I'm not going to go this way. I'm going to change.
Yes.
I'm going to ask for help because I can't do it myself.
Yep.
I have to go to a physiotherapy class.
Yes.
Group.
Well, the thing,
and they will say, yes, we can help you. If you are willing to help yourself,
of course,
we can help you.
Unless you want to help yourself, nobody can help you.
So you know, okay? Now, I'll give you an example. There was a man there I saw, I went along with, I forced Annette.
Yes.
And we went along to the first session. And it's boring as batshit.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So Annette's doing her thing, and it's boring, okay? However, I saw this man doing these most unbelievable exercises. Up and down and around and Superman, unbelievable. And I was in awe of him. And I said to him, I can't believe that a physical body can do what you just did.
Yes.
And if I had a camera, I would have filmed it. Because it was a perfect example to people what to do.
Exactly.
I can't do it, but I admire that.
I admire, exactly.
And he said,
yes.
I had no choice. My back was killing me. I couldn't move because of my back. But I came along here 2 years ago and I come every day since.
Wow.
And his unbelievable movement.
Yes.
But he has the price he has to pay.
Yeah.
He has to do it every day. Now, I don't know what he does outside of that.
Yes.
However, to me, if the new Michael Kazan is being reborn,
yes,
and he's got his physical health, well-being, and loses weight and flexes his muscles and joints and all this, he will be capable of changing the world.
Very good advice, Mr. Stefano, as always.
Would you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Okay, so over here, I switch on, right?
Yep.
Simple. It'll be a similar controller that you'll have.
Yeah.
Well, it might be different brands, but very similar. And you've got different things there. So it's a matter of having confidence with it. And in this particular case, it's, I'm looking for my, how am I going to go? So I go along here, I go along, because I'm wanting YouTube. Okay?
Yep.
So I press YouTube and it comes up. And then I can watch anything on YouTube. Okay? Now it comes up there because I've got Chris Nesty.
Yes.
But it shouldn't be there. Okay? Yeah. But there are lists of other things there. Exactly here, all this list of stuff here. Right? It's key, geared to what I like.
Yes.
And their computer, the mumbo jumbo, automatically chooses things. But don't let it choose, you choose, okay?
Yes.
So it's going back here. In order to do that, you must go back here to home, up to search, across, and type in what you want to search.
Yes.
So you might want to search whatever the subject is. You type it in, so...
Yes, but how do I know what to choose? I mean, what's in? Yeah.
So what are you interested in?
Yeah, but you've done so much work. How can I remember what you've done?
Okay, so you type in Emmanuel Stefano.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
Now, just type it up the top there. So E-M-M.
Yeah, no, across. Can't spell Emmanuel.
Okay, so you go across here. I'm got through already. And Emmanuel Stefano comes up.
Right.
And then it's not in necessarily any order.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter. So we go here. Oh, got Mr. Kazan. Continues.
Yes.
And that was launched 12 hours ago.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's hit play. I think I went to the wrong one. Yep, wrong one. So out of it. Back again. See where the right's the circle.
Yeah.
What the right, that's the right one. Okay. And we need a bit of light. The sound.
What's got in the sound?
Activities was the organizing the.
So, this is the beginning of it. It's worthwhile. Because, again, because I've spent so much time on this, it deserves to be from the beginning. Antoni Kolasu
Proskinumena Gade. One of my most successful activities was the organizing the.
Gate 8.
Gate 8.
Boarding at
5 minutes to 4.
Yeah.
So what's the time now?
Sorry?
What's the time now?
I don't know.
No, 15:50.
Huh?
15:50.
15:50, 10 to 4.
And what's the time now, Annette? What's the time now?
Almost quarter to three.
A good hour and 5 minutes, 10 minutes, okay. Yeah. So happy smoking?
Sorry?
Happy smoking?
We'll take him down to gate 8.
No, it's weird, you did that.
You sure it'll be okay?
What would you say? You got his
That's a good sign. Maybe you're right.
I saw it there.
We'll find out.
Then he realised it.
So what's it been like having Michael Kazan visit?
Oh, it's great.
Yeah? What's been great about it?
Yes, I can take it.
Yeah, good.
You can take it?
Yeah, take it on board with me. Yeah, yeah.
So it was worth a chance, huh?
Yeah.
What was that?
Huh?
What was that?
Welcome back.
Oh.
Uh-huh. He said, what was that? When you went,
My niece. But look.
Yeah. It's beautiful, isn't it?
It's a beautiful airport, isn't it? It's good to be there. There's plenty of time, isn't it? Yeah. Good. So tell me about HAPA.
What about a HAPA? What would you like to know about HAPA?
I know nothing about HAPA.
We are a educational committee that we are trying to introduce Greek to the public schools.
To the public schools?
Public schools, yes. We do a lot of wonderful things. In Sydney we have a medical foundation.
Really?
Oh, yes. And they're thriving. They're donating a lot of money back into the community through the foundation and into medical, especially medical.
Mm-hmm. What about Paul Aventis? Tell me about him. Do you know him? Do you know him?
I was with Prometheus, yes, and then I went into Apollon as well.
Mm-hmm.
I went through the chair last year.
Ah, good.
And now I'm with another chapter. I dropped out of Apollon and went into another league. Only for geographical reasons, that's all.
Yeah, we understand. As we get older, we are looking for more easier ways.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's
nice
where
to meet you.
That's
and,
it's a pleasure to meet you as well.
The photographer asked you if you know me. Do you know me at all?
Unfortunately,
I'm a Canberran, and I'm the grand.
So what do you know about him? What do you know about him?
Actually, if it wasn't for that and that, absolutely nothing. I never met this gentleman. He's my brother, though.
He's your brother-in-law. He's a star in the video I've been making for 40 years.
Really?
He's number one. You don't know? You don't know the most famous Greek in Canberra? You don't know the most important Greek in Canberra?
Actually, funny you should ask that question. I just spoke to my wife on the phone back in 1970. We just got married, 69, 70. We tried to come to Canberra. We didn't make it. We nearly became terminal. We had an accident. 69. I said to Maria, I said, guess where I am? I'm outside Collector now. That's what it happened, Collector.
Outside Collector, eh?
Yes. And this is my first. I finished the trip today.
Anyway, nice to see you here.
It took me for years to come.
Safe and well. Nice
Thank
to see
you very much. It's a pleasure meeting you.
Nice meeting you too. And,
he's lucky you're here.
Catch you later on.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Oh.
εξουσίας εν το κράτημον και του καταξηράν θάλασσα και αέρα, Φιλοκρίστου ημών στρατού. Και σύμπαντος του ευλογημένου ημών γένους.
Κύριε λέει σόλ.
Ότι λέει ημών και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις, και εσύ τη δόξα να αναπέμπουμε, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα την ειν και αεί, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Και εις το Πνεύμα το Άγιο, το Κύριο, το Ζωοποιόν, το εκ του Πατρός εκπορευόμενον, το Συν Πατρί και Υιός υπροσκυνόμενον και συνδοξαζόμενον, το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών. Οι προφήτε ως είδων, οι Απόστολοι ως εδίδαξαν, η Εκκλησία ως παρέλαβε, οι διδάσκαλοι ως εδογμάτισαν, η Οικουμένη ως υπεφώνηκε, η Χάρις ως έλαμψε, η Αλήθεια ως αποδέδειχτε, το Ψεύδος ως απενήλατε, η Σοφία ως επαρησιάσατο, ο Χριστός ως ευράβευσε, ούτω φρονούμε, ούτω λαλούμε, ούτω κηρύσσουμε Χριστόν τον αληθινόν Θεόν ημών. Και τους αυτού Αγίους εν λόγοις τιμώντες, εν συγγραφές, εν νοήμασι, εν θυσίες, εν αείς, εν εικονίσμασι. Τον μένος Θεόν και Δεσπότην προσκυνούντες και σέβοντες, τους δε διό των κοινών δεσπότην ως αυτού γνησίους θεράποντας τιμώντες και την κατασχέση προσκύνηση απονέμονες.
Την άκρα των εικόνα σου προσκυνούμε αγαθέ, ετούμενης η χώρηση των τεσμάτων ημών, Χριστέ ο Θεός, πουλήσει καρυδότησας σαρκή.
Ομολογώ, εν βάπτισμα εις άπτυσιν αμαρτιών, πρόσδοκο ανάσταση νεκρών,
Very good.
Αυτή η πίστη στον Αποστόλο, αυτή η πίστη στον Πατέρα, αυτή η πίστη στον Ορθοδόξο, αυτή η πίστη την Οικουμένη εστήριξε. Επί τούτης, τους της Ευσεβίας Κήρυκας, αδελφικώστε και πατροποθήτως, εις δόξαν και τιμή της Ευσεβίας, υπερείς αγωνίσαντο, ανεφημούμεν και λέγομεν, τον της Ορθοδοξίας προμάχων ευσεβών, βασιλέων, αγιωτάτων πατριαρχών, αρχιερέων, διδασκάλων, μαρτύρων, ομολογητών, αιωνία η μνήμη.
Αιωνία η μνήμη. Αιωνία η μνήμη. Αιωνία αυτών η μνήμη.
Τούτων της υπερευσεβίας μέχρι θανάτου άθλιστε και αγωνίσμασε και διδασκαλίες παιδαγωγίστετε και κρατήνεστε Θεό εκλυπαρόντες και μιμητός της ενθέου αυτών πολιτείας μέχρι τέλους αναδείχνηστε εκδισοκούντες αξιοδείμε των εξετουμένων ειδηρμής και χάριτη του μεγάλου και πρώτου αρχιερέως Χριστού του αληθινού Θεού ημών πρεσβείες της υπερενδόξου δεσποίνης ημών Θεοτόκου και Παρθένου Μαρίας, των φωτοειδών αρχαγγέλων και πάντων των Αγίων. Αμήν. Τις και των τεσσαράτων αμαρτίων, Νικολάου Αρχιεπισκόπου, μύρου της Λυκείας του Θαυματουργού και πάντων των Αγίων, της αυριανής μεγάλης εορτής του Ευαγγελισμού της Θεοτόκου. Σήμερα στις 6 ο Εσπερινός. Αύριο το πρωί κανονικά η Πανηγυρική Θεία Λειτουργία για τον Ευαγγελισμό της Θεοτόκου 8:30. Την Τετάρτη το πρωί προηγιασμένη Θεία Λειτουργία. Παρασκευή το απόγευμα η δεύτερη χαιρετισμή. Παρακαλώ πάρτε στο πρόγραμμά σας και ελάτε στις ακολουθίες. Μόνο έτσι θα καταλάβουμε ότι έρχεται το Πάσχα. Μυρίζει Σαρακοστή με τις ακολουθίες, με το λιβάνι, με όλα τα μυστήρια. Εύχομαι σε όλους τη σημερινή μεγάλη εορτή της Κυριακής της Ορθοδοξίας και πολύ ωραία φέρατε όλοι από τα σπίτια από μία εικόνα να ευλογηθεί. Εύχομαι χρόνια πολλά σε όλους. Διευκόν των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς.
Αμήν.
Καλημέρα σας, βοήθειά μας.
Έλα. Φοριού. Οκ. Εντάξει, ντροπές.
Περάστε παρακαλώ δίπλα για τον καφέ.
Yeah, the dancing guy.
Oh, dancing?
Yeah.
Oh, we have it tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yeah, so it'll be good. Yeah.
At the club?
Yeah, at the club. We're going to have it at the club. I think Kefi Band's going to be there as well. And we're going to do a lot of dancing. It'll be good fun. Yeah. Kefi. Yeah, I think we're going to have to wear tsuriyas as well. So that'll be fun. Haven't done that in a while. That'll be good. How are you today?
I'm not there.